Everyone, good afternoon from EQ International Magazine. I'm Prasoon Agrawal, and today I'm here with some senior officials of Sova Solar. And we have Mr. Krish Mukherjee, who is the Chief Operating Officer, Mr. Swamyan Mukherjee, President of Sova Solar, Mr. Shaugata Datta, who is Advisor, Sales and Marketing, and Mr. Amal Kumar Nayak, who is Head Sales and Marketing for Sova Solar. Welcome, everyone. So first of all, I would like to begin this discussion with a small introduction of your company, Sova Solar. What products offering does it have for the Indian solar market?
Basically, Sova Solar has started its journey in the year 2009. The initial concentration was to supply the modules to the European market, and with that intention it has started with the Spire technology. And after onwards journey of 9th year running, we are having now 200 megawatt installed capacity. We are concentrating on basically full cells modules, and we have launched two new type of products. One is park cell with the 72 cells matrix, and another is 1500 volt module. With this, we are concentrating only on the modules, and some specific EPC job Sova Solar is doing for its branding purpose. But the basic concentration to serve the EPC and developers of the Indian industry with their high efficient modules, this is the main motto and mission of the company. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Swamyan. So how much modules have you supplied to Indian projects presently, and what is the coming pipeline in the next few months?
Since 2011-12, we have cumulatively supplied more than 100 megawatt of modules. And nowadays, it is a very pleasure that this year we will cumulatively supplying expected by end of 31st March 2018, 80 megawatt. So it will be 200 plus megawatt will be supplied by end of this financial year.
Coming on the project cost, I mean, recently we have seen very aggressive bidding in the solar tariffs and prices coming down to around 2.5 per kilowatt. So how does it affect the project viability? What impact does it have on the equipment manufacturers?
I think Mr. Datta will speak.
Yeah, there was a lot of aggressive bidding done on certain assumptions in the global module prices. Even 6 months back, there were predictions that globally the module prices will be at 23 cents per watt. So on the basis of this assumption, it has been quoted, and today the tariffs have been very, very aggressive. But unfortunately, with the recent increase in module prices globally due to the increase in cell prices, these projects have become almost unviable in such small tariff. So it needs to be seen how the developers can squeeze in the cost in other items, bring down the interest cost to compensate for the rise in module prices. But still, it's a very big challenge for them to execute. And that's why you're seeing a lot of projects getting deferred or delayed.
What is the size of your manufacturing facilities, and where are your facilities majorly located? What is the capacity, your manufacturing capacity in terms of megawatt?
Presently, our capacity is 200 megawatt per year, and we are looking to ramp it up to 300 megawatt by the end of March 2018, and our target is to reach 1 gigawatt by 2020.
Any recent noteworthy projects which you might for which you must have supplied your panels to? Any big project which you must have installed recently?
Yes, we have supplied 22 megawatts panels to NLC projects through Jackson, the EPC contractor. They are the EPC contractor. We have supplied 22 megawatts against NLC projects. So this is the current, you know, big projects we have executed. And we are presently we are doing with L&T. There's the Bihar electrification projects is there, rural electrification. There we are going to supply 10 megawatt approx. Is the one projects we are currently working. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Coming on the technology front, how do you see the technology roadmap for the panel manufacturing with the, you know, in terms of 15 volt technology or the per technologies? So what is the technology roadmap, the upcoming roadmap for the panel manufacturing industry?
As already described by Shomen ji, we already have developed the 1500 volts and the PERC cells, and we are also working on the bifacial modules as well as the building integrated photovoltaic modules for this rooftop rooftop projects and for the buildings, and these I think would be developed within the timeline of the next 1 year. And also we are looking at different new technologies which are coming up, like the 5BB and the multi-bus bar systems, and also a very new interesting technology which has come up recently is the pasting type cells which are being developed. But I think the timeline for the implementation of the same would be something around next 3 years. Sova Solar has been constantly trying to improve upon the quality and also to develop new products and remain viable and in the forefront of technology, and that would be our endeavor in the coming days, and we shall strive to maintain our leadership position in this sector.
How has been the performance of your products, and any warranty claim rate, if you have any rejections, any cases of replacement? Have you ever experienced any of these situations?
Regarding the quality issues, what I have already told, we have always strive to do better, and our target, what we could achieve until the end of the last year, we had a rejection ratio of less than 0.03%, and though we are striving to make it below 0.01%, but that's still a process in making, and you know, we already are giving the industry standard warranty claims, and as of now there has been very very minimum claims which has come to us for replacement. But whatever has come, mostly it has been seen that it is coming in a very very rigorous test conditions. Like one example what I can give you is, we had to face a claim in the region in Madhya Pradesh where the solar power plant was located near to a iron manufacturing unit, and it was subjected to very coarse environmental conditions as well as toxic chemicals. So from that we had our learning and we did some developments on our products, and until now we have seen that our products which have been manufactured after the study has been done can withstand such harsh conditions, and we also have done all the new certifications whatever is mandated as well as the new ones which are coming up, so that we maintain our quality standard as per international guidelines.
And one more thing I like to add, that is we have made a collaboration with IIT Kharagpur for our continuous development of our product and process, so that it will be similar to all other branded companies of India and international standard. Thank you.
Now, coming on the larger industry landscape, how do you view the government of India's 100 gigawatt target of solar projects, solar energy by 2022? And what is Sova Solar, Sova Power's commitment in that particular target? How much market share do you target to fulfill out of that 100 gigawatt?
First of all, on behalf of Sova Solar, we would like to thank the Prime Minister for having given Sova and the industry a big materiality in size. So 100 gigawatt has opened the plethora of market in its various forms, right from utility, rooftop and decentralized systems. So Sova has also taken up this challenge of growing in materiality and in size. So our immediate plan this year is to reach 300 megawatts of capacity, and we have already ordered the machines, which are on the way, and by the year 2018-19 we wish to reach 1 gigawatt of solar manufacturing and cater to the customers.
Anti-dumping petition, which has recently been filed in India, has been a hot topic in the industry in recent times, and Sova Solar, being a solar panel manufacturer, seems to be a direct beneficiary, or we can say it affects you in a big way. So what is Sova Solar's general view of the anti-dumping petition, and what is the likely impact of it if it is implemented on Sova Solar?
Basically, anti-dumping duty is a step to protect the Indian domestic industries. But nowadays, if I think that what is the status of Indian industry, of its module manufacturing, its cell manufacturing, backward wafer, India is not in position to combat the with this spoon, this weapon, because for anti-dumping we need the good strength of wafer, cell manufacturing and backward silicon ingot production also we don't have. There is a huge gap of market right now. As per the MNRE declared list, it is 6 gigawatt of module manufacturing, it is 1.5 gigawatt of cell manufacturing nameplate capacity. So there is already gap of 4.5 gigawatt. So if we are not allowing our other competitors, they will stop the supplying of solar cell, and backward integrations wafer will also be heckled. So in a nutshell, anti-dumping at present position, it is not very good step for the Indian industry. It is required to get some protection. Safeguard duty can be welcomed, or some incentive part is welcome to minimize our production cost, so that the ultimate cost curtailment and ultimate cost benefit should pass on to the ultimate consumer. So anti-dumping, in my view, is not the solution for the industry nowadays.
That's some encouraging words to hear from an Indian solar manufacturer. There have also been recent reports on some companies cancelling PPAs, the signed PPAs. So do you think, does it has any relevance to this news, or is it just some false talk kind of a thing?
Okay. Some news has come up. Basically, if we think what we have done in the past and now what we are doing, if we would like to compare those things, it will not be a fair game. At that point, that was the L1 price. Now, you just take the 2 years time span when Sky Power has quoted a very minimum price of 3 rupees 5 paisa. Now everybody has quoted 3 rupees 5 paisa or five rupees. What was Sky Power? 4 rupees 30 paisa. Sorry, I am correcting. And now Avaada Solar has quoted is 2.64. yesterday it has come 2.67. So if we compare that period, it was costlier. So it will not be a fair game. We have to think what we have done. It is closed at that time. It should be continued. Otherwise, industry will be in a dicey position. It cannot sustain for a long run.
So with this, I would like to put an end to this interview. I thank you, gentlemen, for your time and this opportunity. Mr. Amal Nayak, Mr. Shaugat Datta, Mr. Soumyan Mukherjee, and Mr. Krishnendu Mukherjee. Thank you so much for your time, sir.